Hi there, my name is Hazal Sener, Senior Developer Advocate at SqlDBM. In today's video, we will explore how to establish a direct connection to the Databricks Unity Catalog and Hive Metastore Lakehouse architecture components. Let's start by introducing SqlDBM for those who might not be familiar with the tool. SqlDBM is an online database modeling and designing tool that's hosted natively in the cloud. It also offers a data governance and schema monitoring services, but its primary focus is on helping you to model the databases. SqlDBM interacts to work seamlessly with the SQL workspaces in the databases. So this is our homepage. Through here, you will find the access to the dashboard. From there, I will dive into a demo that shows how to establish a direct connection to the lakehouse. The dashboard is where you will discover all the existing projects. To showcase the direct connection to the Databricks Unity Catalog and Hive Metastore, let's create a new project through here. The tool displays the list of databases that we support. I will select the Databricks option. You can bring your DDL manually by copying and pasting through the editor here, or you can drop a SQL file through here. But today we are focusing on the direct connection, so I will click on this option. Here, we have two connection methods, engineering clusters and Unity Catalog API. The main technical differences between these two approaches are the compute resource consumption and the underlying the logic. Let's begin with engineering clusters to see the use case in detail. So, in Databricks, retrieving the DDL is done at the object level. This means that the more objects you have, the more show create table SQL statement you have to run. To simplify this, we have automated the process using a Python code that loops through all the objects in the chosen schemas. The Python code runs using clusters in Databricks, which is why this option is referred to as engineering clusters. On the other hand, Unity Catalog API uses the Databricks GET API functionality. The advantage here is that you don't need to run any clusters or warehouses to use this option to connect to the Unity Catalog. It exclusively connects to the Unity Catalog as Databricks currently applies API functionalities only to the Unity Catalog. So, as a summary of those connection methods, if you are only on Hive Metastore and you haven't upgraded to the Unity Catalog yet, you can only use the engineering clusters. If you are on the Unity Catalog, you can use both connection methods. The only difference that I mentioned earlier, Unity Catalog API option doesn't consume any compute resources. So let's start with the Unity Catalog API option. Here we need some parameters, which are the server and the personal access token. Let's take a look at the Databricks, where we can get these inputs. The server can be taken from the browser, cluster properties, or SQL warehouses. Let's use the option of the clusters, where we can get the server mentions. Let's navigate to the compute. Here you can select the cluster. Then we scroll down, click on advanced options. Here there's a section which is called JDBC ODBC. We are gonna click on it and then we will be able to see the server name. So I can copy the host name and paste in SqlDBM. And the personal access token is at the user level. So every user has to navigate to the user settings to create the personal access token by navigating to the developer session. Here, where you can create a personal access token and introduce this personal access token into SqlDBM. Here, there's a point that I would like to highlight. Personal access token will have exactly the same permissions or restrictions as the user has. So creating a personal access token and introducing this into SqlDBM, you are not going to define and grant full permissions or full access to your workspace. It is going to be limited as the user's permission. I introduced the parameters to SqlDBM, server and the personal access token. Then I'm gonna hit the connect to Databricks. The tool is going to bring me all the Unity catalogs that personal access token has permission to see. For this demo, we are going to select SqlDBM underscore demo and then some multiple schemas to bring into project. Once we hit apply, the tool is going to parse on the left side underlying the Databricks objects. So let's hit the import. And we are going to talk about suggest relationships later. So I can see from here, some constraints were predefined in the database. Once I did the reverse engineering, the tool was able to build those relationships between the entities. So those relationships and constraints were already defined in the database. As you know, Databricks introduced the Unity catalog that supports the constraints, so you might have some constraints defined at the table creation. But likewise, the other databases, Databricks doesn't enforce you to create any constraints at the table creation. In this case, you might have some tables without any key mentions, neither any constraint creations, like those examples. We have a feature which is called suggested relationships. It is going to be navigated through here. Suggested keys are based on the naming patterns. By default, there are some keywords your primary key may contain at the naming convention, but you can extend the list, or you can exclude some columns can't be the part of your primary key. After defining the list, we are going to hit find virtual primary keys, and the tool is going to scan all the objects here by the keywords that we just introduced. Thinking that those suggestions are fine, and then we are going to hit create the virtual primary keys. This is going to be marked as VP key. And now let's create the suggested relationships at the top of the virtual keys. It's going to be same practices. We are going to hit find the virtual relationship option, and the tool is going to list me the parent tables, child tables, and the columns that are related to each other. After reviewing the suggestions, you can create those relationships, and it is going to be marked with different color in the tool, so you will be able to see what has been brought directly from the database and what has been created through the tool. We also support some Databricks special features like table properties. Table properties are the key value pairs that are the governance features. There are user-defined metadata in Databricks, so we can reverse engineer them, and then you can edit the existing one by clicking on it, renaming the property name or defining different property value through here. There is also an option here that you can delete an existing property, or there's another option where you can add a new property from scratch. Let's say the value is 1. We can go back and the table property will be created, and this is going to reflect your DDL as well. The other Databricks special feature is the file format. Once you click on the table, there is an options here. So under the options, you will be able to see the file format. By the reverse engineer, the table imported with Delta file format, but there is an option here that you can change it. Let's change the file format to Parquet, and then you can navigate to the compare revisions to see all the changes between those revisions that you are creating after hitting the save button, or directly navigate to the forward engineering, create either SQL script from scratch or generate an alter script through here. Let's create a SQL script from scratch, and the DDL is going to look like this. As we change the Delta to Parquet, it is going to reflect here. At this table, we did some change table properties. We added a new property. We will be able to see those changes that have been implemented. All right, we covered the direct connection to Unity Catalog using API. Now let's talk about engineering clusters to connect to the Hive Metastore. To be able to use this connection method, the cluster has to be running. Otherwise, the tool is going to give you a message saying that cluster is not running and the connection is not going to be done successfully. The input parameters are very similar to the API method. The server and the personal access token is exactly the same. Additionally, there is one more input parameter here, which is HTTP path. And this is also going to be taken from the cluster properties. Let's take a look at where to take it from and how to run the cluster. Through the compute, we can run the cluster that we are going to use in SqlDBM. We will navigate to cluster properties again to be able to take the HTTP path. And through here, advanced options, as we navigated earlier through the JDBC, ODBC, where we can see the HTTP path. While the cluster is getting ready to run, I'm going to copy this and paste into SqlDBM. After introducing the input parameters, let's hit connect to Databricks. The tool is going to list all the Unity catalogs, including the Hive Metastore. So for this example, let's hit the Hive Metastore. We can select one or multiple schemas like we did before, and then we are going to hit apply. So behind of the scenes, the tool is going to run the Python script to loop all the objects into a Hive Metastore. Here you can review the DDL quickly that we get from the Hive Metastore. You will be also able to see the table properties likewise and file formats, but not the constraints mentioned, unlike Unity Catalog supports. I don't expect to see any entities will be connected after I import all the entities into a diagram. We can review the Hive Metastore objects from the selected schema. There is no any key mentions, neither any connections, any constraints between those objects. So here it is going to be the same practices like we did for the Unity Catalog. You can create the virtual primary and foreign keys, and the tool is going to mark them with VP key. Also, you can create a suggested relationship at the top of those virtual keys. After reviewing it, you can create those relationships and apply star of the layout. In this case, you can reverse engineer your entire Hive Metastore, although there is no any constraints mentioned, neither keys. The tool is going to allow you to build all the relationships automatically based on the naming patterns. Our tool doesn't only reverse engineer your entire lakehouse, you will be able to do some changes over the existing table or creating a new table, adding some columns through here, generate the reference lines by dragging and dropping off, or you can bring some multiple columns from different entities into a table that you have just created. So this table creation is going to be reflected to your DDL. And let's hit the save button. If you are gonna navigate to the format engineering, we can double check there won't be any key mention as it is virtual primary keys and virtual relationships. So from here, you can still forward engineer your DDL, either alter statement or create statement to your Hive Metastore using our API integration or Git integration. You will be able to generate those objects or apply the alter statement to your existing objects in Hive Metastore. Thank you for joining me in exploring these direct connection methods.